It's just one of those days in the great blight. Few more sleeping rough bulldogs getting bited, disseminating daily doses of hate, calculated collapse of the welfare state. It's just one of those days in the great blight. Few more sleeping rough bulldogs getting bited, disseminating daily doses of hate, calculated collapse of the welfare state. And it's a state of hate where those where mandates don't relate. How many times we got to follow this farce, repeating the past, this way of life that just can't last. Yet we don't address the issues, tie ourselves to the mast until the last tree falls, birdsong calls. And only after that, when we've all got our backs to the walls, we'll be able to keep our brothers out, mothers out, significant others out. When we realize the fallacy of not providing help, how can we turn up our nose at those that need it? How can we barely look after beings already alive yet keep on breeding? We need some introspection, a worldwide reflection, encompass a little compassion and love and our quarterly projections. But it's business as usual, and our abstraction from atrocities is useful. We use degrees of separation that sedate our indignation, hold our comfortable complacence till the trauma doesn't phase us. Megalomaniacs chop and change the facts, stack up racks of cash, avoid tax. Promises they vow to keep hold no meaning, the lies that they spew devoid of all feeling. And as the existential crisis looms, they all just sit back while we all choke on the fumes. Feed us nebulous news, disillusion your youth, obfuscating the truth, while our minds get sicker from the propaganda machines producing demagogues. Exponential data sets on your Joe blogs, a digital data deluge comes at a cost. It's no fucking wonder that the populace has started to feel lost. The systematic symptoms of chaos against order, silence of the lambs that are led to the slaughter. And what are we to do when we live in this land? Polarized views. One of those days in the great blighted, few more sleeping rough bulldogs getting bited, disseminating daily doses of hate, calculated collapse of the welfare state. One of those days in the great blighted, few more sleeping rough bulldogs getting bited, disseminating daily doses of hate, calculated collapse of the welfare state. Two-dimensional stereotypes spun to and fro from left to right, categorize and rank each other down the line, slice right through the middle, clean cut, no compromise, stirring the pot, feeding the lions. And it's frustrating that we take the bait, make these mistakes, but it's an age-old trick they've learned to cultivate. It's the telltale signs of Machiavellian traits, it's the telltale signs of narcissistic characteristics, take the reins by ballistics, but one of them has any notion of life beyond the vote statistics. No second thought, help for those on the street, or for single parents praying that the ends meet. Nah, now they're much more concerned with their legacy, hoping somehow they'll be marked down in history. Yeah, and they're much more concerned with the Middle East and funding proxy wars that aid the oligopolies. And despite all of us that see the wood for the trees, they'd rather spray the tear gas and listen to our pleas. And they'll continue on the path to bring the earth to its knees, till it shakes us off like a bad case of the fleas. One of those days in the great blighty, few more sleeping rough bulldogs getting bitey, disseminating daily doses of hate, calculated collapse of the welfare state.